Well, good morning, Beth-EL and beyond, and welcome to another installment of Sing Along with Cantor Melissa. And as always, I'm happy to be with you on another morning for another sing along with you. And hopefully you're able to take a break with me and hear some beautiful music and share some beautiful music with me. So I'm sticking with my themes, and I always try to be mindful of what's going on in the calendar and sensitive to what's going on in the calendar. I try to do that during my services as well. And so when I'm looking at the calendar around now, of course, next Monday and the whole weekend, we'll be celebrating Memorial Day, which of course will be, like I said, next Monday. And then the following week, we'll be celebrating Shavuos. I still say Shavuos. I know, Shavuot. Same thing. So I figured that this morning that we would have some beautiful music to commemorate and pay tribute and pay honor to our beautiful country and the men and women who sacrifice many, many things, including their own lives, to make that country beautiful for all of us. And so that's what Memorial Day is about. Here in Indiana, historically, we have a big race, and it's usually a time of joy and being together and people being with one another. And yes, having celebrations and coming together in a different way, but also recognizing Memorial Day. And things will look different this year. There's no race. The race, I understand, is being postponed and certainly will look different when that's going to happen in August, as I understand the case to be. But nonetheless, we will pay tribute this morning in honor. Many of those of you who know me personally know that I am a true patriot. I love my country. I am a very, very proud Jewish American. I am the granddaughter of immigrants. I am the great-granddaughter of another set of immigrants. I'm the daughter of a very, very proud Navy veteran. I am the granddaughter of a proud Army veteran of blessed memory. My grandfather fought in the Great War, the World War II, that is, and he was the proud and decorated Army War veteran. And on this day, I wanted to make some special music and honor these people, these men and women who do give everything. And I wanted to also share a little bit of Yiddishkeit, some Jewishness about Memorial Day. So you should know that that Jewish Americans have served in every single armed conflict in our country since colonial times. So I think that that's really very notable, actually. So before the country was even the United States of America, Jews have been fighting and defending our nation. So that's amazing to me. So there's not great documentation on the history of the early Jews in the armed forces, but it is noted that a gentleman named Francis Salvador, and note the last name Salvador is obviously of Sephardic, is of Sephardic lineage. And I noted a few weeks ago when we had our Cinco de Mayo theme day that the first immigrants to come to, that the first people to come and settle, the first Jews to come and settle in our country were, of course, of Sephardic origin. So no surprise there that Francis Salvador was the first Jewish American to die serving our country in the Revolutionary War. I also want to note a gentleman named Chaim Salomon, who was notably a very good friend, a dear friend to George Washington, and he was a key financier in the Continental Army and really helped keep the army going in our fight for independence and in our fight to create this country that we now call home, this nation that we now call home. So he was a Polish Jew who had come to immigrate to this country. And of course, we can't say it enough. We are a nation of immigrants, and we fight for our beautiful country, and we serve this beautiful country, and we will continue to do so. So I figured we would start our sing-along this morning with a beautiful song written by a Russian Jewish immigrant named Irving Berlin. And he composed this song, God Bless America, in 1918, while he himself was serving in the United States Army. He wasn't stationed overseas at the time. He was actually stationed in New York, and he was writing a ditty for a play. But he didn't think that it went actually with the play, so it was reused, and it became a hit. And then it resurfaced. He himself actually offered it to someone named Kate Smith, who then revitalized it in 1938 as a peace song. And we'll talk about peace songs in just a moment. But it became another instant hit as a peace song in 1938 when the rise of Hitler and World War II was upon our country. So here is God Bless America, written by Irving Berlin. Should be our nation's Star-Spangled Banner, our Star-Spangled Banner, our national anthem, and for many it does serve as a sort of a second national anthem. And of course, it's played at all sorts of sporting events and gatherings of large sorts. So God bless America, keeping us all together. So America. So. People do, the immigrant way of coming to America has been happening since the start of our country. So since those people came to the country, those very first immigrants from the Sephardic origin, and then later from Europe, and still today, even we as Americans now are always in search of that America that we love. And we are still trying to find our America. And so there's this beautiful song that I just love, and it's by Paul Simon, who was born in Newark, New Jersey in 1941. And he was born, he's a Hungarian Jew, and so he was born of Hungarian ancestry, and you know, the immigrant story, which is such the story of our country, where you know they just get up and they find their America. And so I thought that I would share this song with you. I'm always enamored by this song because you know, it references New Jersey, and I love New Jersey, so gotta get it in there. So from me to you, here's America, and I hope that the kavanah with this song should be that you are always finding your place in this beautiful land that we call our own. And if you're ever on a road trip and you're just looking out the window and you see how the land changes as you go on, always makes me think of this song and how you can search for yourself in our land. Great singer-songwriters, also a Jewish guy named Robert Zimmerman. He was born in Duluth, Minnesota, also in 1941, and he's a proud Sigma Alpha Mu from the University of Minnesota. And he went on to become one of our greatest, most recognized singer-songwriters, folk singers in our country, and wrote all sorts of peace songs, a little bit different than the peace songs that we heard earlier from Irving Berlin and made famous by Kate Smith. Anyone? Bob Zimmerman? Anyone? I'll check my comments here. Nope. Anyone? Bob Dylan! So here is a peace song from 1962. So things are a little different when you think of a peace song from 1938, which shows this great sense of patriotism and sense of America and sense of duty to your country, and just shows how the scenery changes and how the environment changes in politics and with people in the social And the social sense, then you have Bob Dylan writing songs like Blowing in the Wind in 1962. And it's funny because here we are in 2020, and I ask myself, gosh, I wasn't around in 1962 for sure, but you know, my parents were, and I hear them talk, and I know that things were, you know, a certain way socially then, and it doesn't seem that we found that answer in the wind yet. So I hope that we find that answer, and we'll still be on that search together. That answer together. So I am going to sing a song now from a show. I'm going to sing a show tune for Memorial Day. And this is a show tune from, well, I think that this would definitely qualify as my all-time favorite Broadway show, for sure. So this is a song from Les Miserables, and it's a song about bringing a soldier home and back to his family where he belongs. And when I think about Memorial Day, I think of this song and the words of this song, because we sometimes take for granted all those folks, all those men and women who are out there serving our country so that we can be here and free to live our lives in safety and in comfort, and that there are men and women who don't return to their families. And this is a prayer to bring the soldiers back. And so I sing this with that in mind, and so that we can remember those who have fallen and those who have served. So my favorite psalm in all of the psalms, in all of Tehillim, is 145. And I know, 145, which one is not 145? Well, it's not the one with all of the instruments, that's 150. And so it's, and it's not the other one, and it's not the other one, it's Psalm 145. And this is commonly known as Ashrei. It's an acrostic, right? From Aleph to Tav. And I teach this one very diligently to our Bar and Bat Mitzvah students. And it's the first psalm that I learned in its entirety when I was a little one. And I know it by heart, and it's one of those psalms that I say, it's a psalm that you keep in your pocket because you need it. That's why we have the Tehillim. We keep them in our pocket to pray when we need them, in good times and in bad times, in happy times and in sad times, and they're there for whatever you need. So 145 is one that I say covers kind of everything, and that's part of the reason why I love teaching it. So 145, known as Ashrei, there is that I'm going to sing a song which actually does not come from the Jewish heritage at all. It comes from from the Baptist heritage, and from the Baptist hymnal. But it is based on the words of Psalm 145, and I love it because what it says is, even in these times that are not right, like we're in right now, when things are a little bit off, when things are uncertain, I can still find the beauty in things. And that's what I've been trying to do for the past, 9 or 10 weeks now. And, just trying to find every silver lining that I possibly can, and having a straight and outward look. And so I ask myself, because it's easy to say, you know, there's no music, I can't go to the theater anymore, but no, I say to myself, how can I keep from singing all of this stuff around me that's not going on, that's great, but at the end of the day, I can sing, I have my voice, and I have my family, all of this beauty around me, so I ask myself, how can I keep from singing, and so we have this beautiful song, and that's one of the beautiful messages in Psalm 145, so here's a rendition of this beautiful song. Thank you. So our last song of the day is tribute to, again, our beautiful country. And the first verse, of course, I'm sure that you all know, America the Beautiful, and the music was written by a church organist named Sam Ward. And the beautiful words were written by Catherine Lee Bates. And, they were written, looking upon and gazing upon the beauty of our natural world, looking at Pike's Peak. And, I'm so lucky that I have parents who have traveled with me around our beautiful country to see places like Pike's Peak and the Grand Canyon and all of these gorgeous places that I get to call home in this nation. And so to be able to see those purple mountain majesties that she was actually talking about in this poem, and that I get to live amongst amber waves of grain now here in Indiana, of course, and look upon the beautiful spacious skies is really just a wonder. So of course you're all familiar again with this first verse, but I'll add in a few other lesser known verses that are appropriate for the day. So feel free to sing with me along at home and join me in America the Beautiful as we again pay tribute, honor, and memory those who have served and those who do serve, and of course those who have fallen for the duty of our country.